I'm your host, Gino Washington. As you know, Whitney Houston passed, and today we have a tribute and a celebration for Whitney Houston. I had an opportunity to interview Whitney Houston in California at the NAACP Achievement Award in 1985. This is when she first had got started. The album just went gold, and she just came back from Detroit. So we talked about Detroit, we talked about Aretha Franklin, we talked about her mother, Sissy Houston, and other entertainers that she admired that really got her in the business. And also, the classic interview from 1985.
Hi, this is Gino Washington, and today we have one of the most beautiful ladies in the business today who, so far in her first album, took the United States and the world by storm. Whitney Houston, how you doing?
Hi, fine, how are you?
Fine, and you?
Good.
And she's very beautiful, too.
Thank you.
Who have you been singing?
I've been singing since I was a child. I've been singing for a long time.
Did you used to watch your mother
Yeah, I watched Mom, I watched Aretha, I watched a lot of people.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Did you want to be a singer?
Not always.
What you really wanted to be?
I was always able to sing, but I never wanted to make it my profession until I was about 12 or 13. Mm-hmm. But I either wanted to be a teacher or a veterinarian.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
But you chose singing like me. I want to be a lawyer, but I chose singing in television.
Well, I think if God gave it to you, you better use it.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm.
And that was your first album. Did you write some of the songs on the album?
No, I didn't. I didn't write any of the songs, no.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. How did it feel when you listened to the radio and you heard your first recording? How did that feel to you?
It's a feeling that you can't ever imagine. It feels good to know that they're playing it and that you hear yourself. And it never sounds the same, but it just feels good, mm-hmm. You know? It feels good.
When you found that the record was number one in the country, how did you feel then?
Ecstatic. That's all I can say.
Your whole album is dynamite.
Mm.
Tell me a little bit about you.
What do you want to know?
Everything. Not everything.
No, I can't
but,
tell you that.
But what is your hobbies?
I like to swim. I like to play tennis, relax, read a little, play music. That kind of thing.
And you are a dynamite performer.
Thank you.
Because the center, a lot of entertainers come to Detroit, okay?
Mm-hmm.
And first time out, and you really took them by storm.
Oh.
And the reports were really fantastic.
Good.
That you're very dynamite.
Thank you. Thank you.
How does it feel to be traveling the country now and meet new people?
It's wonderful. I'm touring, and the shows have been great as far as I'm concerned, and I'm having a good time. I'm enjoying it.
Did you find it rather hard getting into the business, really? First, by your mother, did compare your mother and you?
No, I don't think that you can ever compare me and my mother, or me and Dion, for that matter.
Which is your cousin, right?
Yes, he was my cousin. Because we are different people, and we're sort of different kind of singers, but we derive from the same blood. So, you'll find Dion and me, I'll find Dion,
mm-hmm.
and my mother and me and my mother, and me and Dion, you'll see us all, because we're family.
Did you learn a lot from both of them?
Yes, I did, very much.
And
yes.
It really is paying off.
What better people to do it from?
Right, in the future.
Mm-hmm.
In the future, in your recordings, what do you look forward to?
Just good music.
Good music.
Good music.
And you're making that.
Thank you.
I want to thank you.
You're welcome.
Whitney, for this beautiful interview.
You're welcome.
And continued success.
Thank you.
And personally, I think you're very dynamite, very sweet.
Thank you.
Entertainer. But all that roll into one, there's no way that you're going to miss.
All right. Thank you
very much. This is Gino Washington. We're going to take a pause on the call, and we'll be right back with more. Thank you.
This last video is a very special video. And it was sung by Whitney Houston. But let me tell you a story about this song. This song was written by George Benson for Muhammad Ali in the movie Cassius Clay. And what she did, she took his rendition and did it again herself and blew it away. There's another artist also that did the same thing. That was Aretha Franklin, Respect. Respect was written by Otis Redding, and he performed it. But Aretha Franklin came back out and killed it. So it shows you these two artists took other superstar songs and killed it. Also, I Always Will Love You by Dolly Parton. Dolly Parton sung it, and then what happened? Whitney got it and tore it up. And ain't too many stars can do that.